In this series, we will be sharing some beautiful tourist places of Andhra Pradesh, which became so memorable to us that we feel that it will steal your heart as well. From Howrah, we came to Vijayawada to explore the city in a day's time.
An important city in the southern part of India and also being one of the largest one in the region, the city of Vijayawada, apart from being a thriving commercial hub, also houses the ancient Ondu Valley caves from the 5th century.
Within walking distance from the railway station, we came to a restaurant to have lunch before exploring the city. The meal is for 100 rupees per person.
We came out of the railway station and had lunch from a restaurant near Narayan Swami Hotel. The wage bill cost is only 100 rupees, but it is not tasty at all. From there, we have hired an auto rickshaw and we are going to Ulta Valley Caves. The auto rickshaw bhaiya is charging 120 rupees for one way journey.
The road was quite smooth and the graffiti walls looked colorful and attractive. While enjoying the natural beauty of river and plateaus, we reached the Ondu Valley Caves.
आपका नाम क्या है?
वेंकी.
आपका
बुज्जी बाबू.
आपका आपका भाई
विनय.
आप लोग कहाँ से है?
लोकल.
अच्छा अच्छा ये फर्स्ट टाइम आ रहे हैं यहाँ?
फर्स्ट टाइम नो. ये एवरी संडे
इधर आते हैं आप लोग? यहाँ पे कैसे आते हैं आप लोग? बस मिलती है यहाँ पे?
ये बस आए ये विजयवाड़ा में. ये अमरावती के आए.
अमरावती? अमरावती से?
हाँ अमरावती.
अमरावती यहाँ से 40 किलोमीटर.
40 किलोमीटर से ये विजयवाड़ा टू ये Ondu Valley गृहल के ये 10 किलोमीटर से.
10 किलोमीटर. अच्छा, तो ये विजयवाड़ा बस कहाँ रुकेगी?
बस विजयवाड़ा बस स्टैंड है. आए
विजयवाड़ा बस स्टैंड. अच्छा, प्रकाशम ब्रिज क्रॉस करके?
हाँ यस.
ओके,
सीता नगर में ये आए बस.
थैंक यू.
We saw few buses flying from the Ondu Valley caves, but maybe for the language barrier, the local people couldn't guide us properly and we had to reserve an auto rickshaw. The entrance ticket is rupees 25, but if you book from the ASI website, then it is only 20 rupees for the Indian citizens. The ground floor of the Ondu Valley Caves is an unfinished pillared hall and there is not much of artistic beauty. So now we will move towards the first floor.
Mm-hmm.
four-storied cave carved from a monolithic rock. We are at present in the first floor, and immediately at the entrance we can see the sculpture of Ganesh Bhagwan.
Though predominantly dedicated to Vishnu Bhagwan, it also houses sculptures of numerous other Hindu gods and goddesses.
From various written sources, it is retrieved that the artwork was initiated by the Vishnu Kundina kings in the 5th and 6th century, who were patrons of both Shaiva and Vaishnav cult. We are in the second floor of the four-storied cave, and over here we can see various sculptures of Lord Vishnu and his incarnations. Over here we can see the Varaha avatar of Lord Vishnu, and in the next pillar we can see the avatar of Narasimha killing the demon king Hiranyakashyap. In this pillar, Lord Ram, who is another incarnation of Lord Vishnu, has been sculpted.
Every corner of it exhibits age-old carvings, such intricate and elegant that it makes us gaze in awe.
At one end of the cave, we can see a huge sculpture of Lord Vishnu in the reclining posture. And over here, he is worshipped as Padmanabha Swami. By the way, the richest temple of the world is Padmanabha Swami Temple of Kerala's Thiruvananthapuram. From the navel of Lord Vishnu, we can see the emergence of a lotus on which Lord Brahma is seated. There is a no entry board at the fourth floor of the cave, and the sculpture of the saints at my back made the appearance of the cave more beautiful.
We descended to the main road to catch a bus to the Vijayawada city center. We again crossed the Prakasham barrage to reach the main city.
By bus number 301 from Undavalli Caves, we have come to the Vijayawada city bus stand. I mean Vijayawada bus stand, the city bus stand is nearby, we are going over there now.
We waited for the arrival of the Kanak Durga temple bus, which take the pilgrims to the top of the hillock.
From the city bus stand, we are going to the Kanak Durga Mandir. It is around 2 kilometers from here, and we have boarded the temple bus. The bus fare is 10 rupees per person.
Within a short while, we reached the top of the hill, and the view from there was very beautiful.
We have reached the Kanak Durga temple, who is the presiding deity of Vijayawada, and we need to deposit the camera, bag and shoes in the cloakroom.
Built in the Dravidian style of architecture, the Kanak Durga temple is intricately designed with a touch of elegance.
Actually, the mobile phone is allowed inside the temple complex, but photography is not allowed inside the temple. There was no rush inside the temple, and we completed the darshan in 15 minutes.
The Krishna River flows on one side and the city of Vijayawada thrives by its bank. After spending some time, it was time to return to the Vijayawada railway station to continue our journey to the offbeat places of Andhra Pradesh.